Hello everyone, welcome to a new tutorial in the course of MRI preprocessing techniques. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about registration. What is registration? Registration is a technique to transform an image and make it occupy the same physical space and have the same shape as a reference image. It is useful to align multiple images and ensure a spatial correspondence with an image. We can think of it as another method to standardize images. So let's see how it works. So now we're going to do registration of a raw image to a template image. Remember, as in the histogram matching step, we need an image as a reference to do the registration. For registration, it is usually a template, but it could be any image that you define as the standard. Also, in the context of registration for a raw image, we say this image it is in the native space. And for the reference image or target, we say this image it is in the standard space. So given said that, let's review the workflow. The input of the registration, it is the raw image and the template image or target. We do registration of raw image to a standard space, and the output will be the registered image and some transformations. The transformations are only some files that are generated during the registration. We will ignore them by now. So with this picture in mind, let's go with the code. So we have loaded our raw example already. Now we load the template. Remember, this template is the target image we will use to do the transformation. Before continuing, let's check the information of the raw image and the template. So as you can see, some items are different. For example, dimensions are different, the spacing is different, and even the origin vector. It is important to make this analysis because the registered image will have same information as the target image. So now let's do the registration. To do the registration, we call the method ants.registration. We pass as a fixed parameter the template. We're going to pass as the moving parameter the raw image. This is the image we want to transform. So there is this type of transform parameter. I use this string syn. This is a default value that works okay for most of the cases, but you can check the documentation if you want to tune this parameter. So we pass the verbose true parameter, and now we are going to execute this cell. It's going to take some time, so I will pause the video and will continue when it is done. So now the registration has finished. As you can see, now we have some logs that have been generated. It's a bit technical. Let's review in a text editor. So as you can see, this is a bunch of technical stuff about all the operations done during the processing, during the registration algorithm. So we're not going to use this information. It's for you. It's only for you to know it. So now let's print the transformation variable. In this variable, it is contained the transformed image. It corresponds to the key warp move out. We also have this output warp fix out. We have the output of FWD transform. These are the transformations file that I talked to you about earlier. We also have inf transform. So these are the path where the files were placed. So now we're going to get our transformed image. We use the warp move out key. And this contains the registered image as an ants image. So we plot it to see how it looks like. And there we go. So as you can see, it looks pretty much like the raw image we loaded, but it has the shape and the structure of the template. So this is the result of the registration. So the next thing I'm going to do now is to save that result. So here I have the same snippet for saving images as before. So I print out the path of the raw image and the path of the new image, which is a registered image. So I'm going to call the method toFile. I pass the path, and when I execute this, this should save the image. So now you know how to do registration using Antspy and a template. So that's it by now. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.